So you've just put in your brand new lithium battery system. You've got a lithium battery, you've got a charger, you're set for solar, but you can't track what your battery's doing. We've just gone out and we've grabbed 500 amp shunt battery monitor kit from iTechWorld. Guys, this is pretty much the only way you can monitor what your batteries are doing with lithiums. Now, guys, I've got a discount code for you. If you watch to the end of the video, I'll chuck it on the screen, or you can have a look in the description box down below. And full disclosure, guys, I paid full retail price for this. I just went to the website, bought this one to match our system. So I want to show you a little bit of the install, see how it all goes together, and exactly what you can expect to see from one of these units. Well, let's get into it. All right, I'll quickly take you up in the van and we'll have a look at how the install goes. Righto, so I'll spin you around and have a quick look at how this shunt gets installed into the system. So you can see there's our 200 amp battery from iTechWorld, and our charger's down here beside it. So the way this system works is your shunt, or your battery monitor, monitors every incoming and outgoing negative of your battery system. So you can see just here, I've got one big negative cable, so that's 200 amp cable. So one cable comes up to the shunt, and then all of the negatives for the whole system comes off this other side of the shunt. So that's monitoring every negative side of every load, every charge, everything in the 12 volt system is through this shunt on this side here, and then connected back to the battery. So it's monitoring everything that goes through here, and then relaying it with this cable right here over to a little display that you can read out. That's pretty basic and simple to understand. So straight underneath, you've got this little red cable here. That's your power cable for the unit. It draws, I think it's 0.001 of an amp. It's bugger all. It's just enough to power the screen and power some little diodes here on the printed circuit board on the back side. But that's about it. Really, really basic and easy. And that's just connected straight back down to the battery. And I've just got this little inline 1 amp fuse just over here, and yeah, that's just protecting that. But that's pretty much the whole brains of the system in a nutshell. Really, really easy to install. I've just got three little screws going through into the timber, and that's what's holding it onto the wall. But other than that, super, super easy. I hope you can see this cable running along the top. I've just got it loosely tied in at the moment, but basically I'm just running that all the way across above the charger and across the top here. I've just got it loosely tied into these little stick-on cable tie holders. So basically you can follow that along, just runs across the top all the way to the corner. So as I said, I've just got it loosely tied. And I've just coiled up all the slack and all the extra excess cable over here in the corner. But from there, it just continues along, plugs in to its little display screen. And if you follow that down and into the corner, you can see that little cable just going out the side of the wall there. That's the display screen. So I'll take you out the side and we'll have a quick look at the screen. So just to give you guys a bit of a look at the display screen, you can see that we've got 5.8 amps coming in at the moment. We've got the solar hooked up. If I come across here, you can see we're at 98.1% and 13.5 volts, so almost full. I'll just scroll across. You can see now we're putting in just over 6 amps, and our capacity is at 196.1 amp hours, so about 4 amp hours to go before we're fully charged. You can see there that we've got the up arrow and a plus symbol. That just tells you that we're actually putting charge into the battery. If that was the opposite way with a minus symbol, you'd know that we were taking power out. But you can see, guys, that it's pretty basic. So you got your percentage readout, your voltage readout, your current amp draw or charge amps, and your remaining amp hour capacity. So it's pretty basic, but it's all the information that you need to know. You don't really need to know anything more than that. And
you can get some more with some fancy bells and whistles like Bluetooth, so you can monitor things while you're out walking around, but you really don't need it, and we didn't need it for our setup, so that's why we've gone with this one. But that's just a little bit of a look at the display screen and what you can expect, what information you can expect to get from it. Righto, so at the moment the van's just sitting here in the front yard. It's set up in a fully off-grid setup at the moment, so we're only charging through solar and running off the battery. So the battery supplies everything at the moment except the fridge, because we're still reusing the old three-way fridge. But I'll give you a look at how we're topping up the battery. So you can see I've got the back boot open at the moment, and just one little cable coming down the backside and in that door. So that plugs straight into the DC-DC charger. You can see just there. And supplying that is a 350 watt fixed flexible panel. So we've got the 350 watt fixed flexible panel mounted onto the roof, and then we've got the option to run a second solar panel that's our 150 watt solar blanket, and we can plug that in as well as the 350 watts if we need some more power. Haven't had to use that one yet, but we've just got a double adapter and some plug set up, and that can plug in with it as well. So anyway guys, there you have it. There's a first look at the iTECH World 500 amp shunt. That's the way we're gonna be monitoring our iTECH 200 lithium battery. And guys, if you wanna get a hold of one of these, if you wanna have a look at iTECH World, I'll leave a link down in the description below where you can suss these out. And I'll also leave our discount code out and about. Use that if you're gonna get any iTECH World product, it'll save you 5%. Knock a little bit of money off and save yourself a little bit of cash. Guys, like I said before, I paid full retail for this. I'm not sponsored or anything like that. This isn't a sponsored video. I just wanted to give you guys a look at how this thing goes into your setup and how it works and how we're gonna be using it in ours. But guys, if you've got any comments, questions, queries at all about our 12 volt system, our setup, the gear we use, all of it, guys, leave a comment below and I'll be sure to get back to each comment. If there's a common theme or anything like that, I'll try to make a dedicated video and go into a bit more depth than just a comment. But guys, as always, get out and about, and we'll see you in the next one.